Hey everybody, it's Pete from FigLife.com. Hey, today I'm going to look at Black Manzanita. I had my first fig ripen today. It's May 25th, which is kind of crazy. So May 25th, I had my first main crop fig ripen, and it happened to be Black Manzanita. Now don't draw the conclusion that that means that this is a super early fig. I started growing these things under the grow lights. I grew this tree from a cutting. I have to look back and see when I actually started the cutting, but it's been growing under grow lights for quite a while, so you shouldn't take away that this is a super early fig, but it is the first actual ripe main crop fig that I've gotten, and so I'm pretty excited to try that. But I'll just show you the tree here. So here's my Black Manzanita tree, and it has some beautiful leaves on it. Looks like they're all the leaves here looking kind of similar, but it seems to be producing fruit really well also. I mean, I've got a bunch of figs on this tree, and the tree is not very big. This is first year. As I mentioned, I started this winter, grew it from a cutting, so I just rooted a cutting, and a lot of figs. Looks like I'm going to get to try a bunch of these this season. The ripe one just fell off, but it was right here. So a lot of good growth from that Black Manzanita, and it looks like some pretty good production as well. So let's go take a look at the fig itself. All right, so here it is, Black Manzanita, my first fig. You can see, of course, really dark coloring to the fig itself, but take a look at the eye there. Let's see if I can get a good shot of that. There we go. Look at that, really tight eye, which is good on the East Coast, or you know, these areas where you have a lot of humidity or pests. If you have a fig with a big open eye, you're gonna have a lot more problems with fruit flies getting in there and different things getting in there and spoiling your fig. So having a tight eye is gonna be really helpful in trying to produce good quality fruit. So the fact that Black Manzanita on this first fig at least has a really tight eye on it is a good sign as far as being able to grow this fig successfully in a climate like this. So yeah, this is looking good. It fell off on its own. I didn't take it off. I just went out. I knew it was getting close, and I just went out and checked it today, and it had actually just fallen off. So ready or not, time to try it. All right, I just went and got a knife so that I could cut it open. So let's go ahead and cut this Black Manzanita open and see what we've got. So normally I'm expecting, I cut open a fig like this, I'm expecting red pulp. But Black Manzanita is known as having really dark pulp inside. Sort of like Galicia Negra is the only other one I can think of that might be comparable in terms of color on the inside. So I'm really interested to see what the coloring is on the inside of this fig. All right. Well, it does have a little bit of that darkening. You know, it looks like it's starting to get dark, but not super dark like some of the photos I've seen from the figs in California. Let me get a close-up of the coloring here. All right, so there's the inside of Black Manzanita. You can see some of that darker coloring around the edges of the pulp there on the inside, but it hasn't gotten that dark coloring all the way through like I've seen in some of the photos from California. And you know, that could be because there's a little bit of spoilage there in the center where it's got that lighter color, or it could be that it just needs to be a little more ripe, or it could be that, you know, just different climate, you're going to get a different sort of response or a different sort of fig coloring. Sometimes taste and look of it can be different when you grow it in a different climate. So, I'll have to look at some more of these and see if they all look like this or if some of them get dark. And then when I taste it here, I'll get a better idea of whether that is actually some spoilage there in the center or if it just normally has like a light color to it. All right. Alright, let me cut this up in quarters here. Just got a little piece of a grape in there, sitting underneath my grapes. Okay, alright, so this is kind of an unusual time of the year to get a fig. It's super early. So sometimes when you grow these figs under the grow lights, and, you know, being the first fig off a new tree, the taste is not as good as it normally would be. So these may not taste very good, but you never know until you try it. So let's give this thing a shot. Black Manzanita. Not a lot of flavor. Just a little bit of sweetness. Yeah, just a little bit of sweetness. Not a lot of... maybe like a really light berry flavor, but so a little bit of sweetness, a little bit of berry, but not like, certainly not knocking my socks off here. But again, way early to be getting main crop figs in Virginia here, super early, mostly grown under the grow lights, so you can't expect too much from this. And then the coloring here was obviously not fully developed, so you know, I'm still pretty hopeful for this fig. You know, being this early in the season, getting some, you know, fig that is edible this early in the season, most of the time this fig being grown under grow lights, you know, I still have pretty high expectations for Black Manzanita. Yeah, I think this fig has promise, but a little more testing, tasting necessary, but happy to try this. Happy to have a fig this early in the season. Again, only May 25th here in Virginia. We got a main crop off Black Manzanita. So, more to follow. And I'll do another video once I get a Black Manzanita that looks a little bit more characteristic of how these figs are supposed to look, and hopefully we'll have a taste that is a little more representative of what people can expect off of this type of fig tree. So check out my website, www.figlife.com. If you got any questions, I email Pete@figlife.com. Thanks for watching.